Let's look at a C implementation of a direct form filter, direct form 2 filter. So C direct form 2 filter. Remember, direct form 2 filter has a characteristic that we have two accumulators. So that's our accumulator 1 and that's our accumulator 2, and then the summation of this accumulator here goes into a delay line, and just one delay line. So we've got just here this delay line, and then we've got coefficients here going back, so that's here multiplied by minus A1, and that's here multiplied by minus A2. And then here we've got our FIR coefficients here, so it's multiplied by B0, and then this is here multiplied by B1, and then this is here multiplied by B2. And so this is our input here, x of n, and this is our output, y of n. So this was the characteristicum that we have just one delay line, but we have got two accumulators. So in a C implementation, that's pretty easy to do. So if we see our, if we want to do this in C, so I just bring up here an editor, so Emacs, and I call this here IIRC, and bring this here to the screen and make it a bit smaller. This here, oops, so that we see still the circuit diagram here. So let's do this like that. So then imagine we would like to create a function. So what we then just need to do is, so we create something like function double, and we call this maybe IIR, or let's just call this just filter, and this also gets a double value, and we call this value. Then what we need to do is, so we need to create two accumulators here, so the accumulator 1 and the accumulator 2. So let's call the accumulator 1 here, let's just call this input accumulator, and we set this to 0. Oops, and we need to obviously tell the type of this. And then we have the output accumulator, and we also set this to 0. Output accumulator is this one here. So this one here is called now our input accumulator, and this is here our output accumulator. And so now we just need to basically follow the recipe what we have in our circuit diagram here. So we have our input, and the input we just store in the summation unit, and then we're adding these two recursive terms to it. So that's all what we need to do. And so therefore our input accumulator underscore accumulator just gets in the first place our value, yeah, so that's here the input, and then our input accumulator. Input accumulator here is subtracted now. So what we do here, so we are subtracting our value minus A1 from this here, A1, and we multiplying this with a delayed version of this one here, and let's call this here buffer 1. coming back to zero, and then we do the same for the next coefficient. I'm a bit lazy here, and I copy and paste that. So we have a coefficient A2, and we have buffer 2, which is the second delay step here. So this one here is now called buffer 1, and this one is here now called buffer 2. And so with that, these are our two delay buffers here, and with that we have calculated our input summation unit here, so this unit here. So this now sends its output straight, not straight, weighted by the factor B0 to the output accumulator. So that's then the next thing what we need to do. So output accumulator equals is then the input, and then this weighted by here the factor B0. And then we just need to add the delayed version to the output accumulator. So the output accumulator gets now the output from the buffer 1 here, and this multiplied by B1. And so we just need to write B1 equals buffer 1. Just to make it look symmetrical. So now I just need to add the second delay step here. And I call this here, that's the output of buffer 2, and this is multiplied by B2. So this one is here, the accumulator for the IIR part. And that's the accumulator for the FIR part. So now the last step is we need to shift our data through the buffer for the next time step. And so that's obviously easy here, so because we've got just two time steps. So then buffer 2 gets a value from buffer 1, and then buffer 1 just gets the input accumulator. So with that, we have just shifted everything through. So the input accumulator, remember, this is basically the value here. The input accumulator, this value flows into the buffer and then is shifted. It's the next time step. So once we have done that, so we just need to return our output value. So here we've got obviously, of course, our output y of n, and in C file, in C style fashion, we just do return output accumulator. And then we just close our bracket, and with that, we have created our direct form 2 filter in C.